This video shows how to import geolocated data to create an environment of work for a construction project. Before we start, let's talk about Coordinate Reference System, or CRS. Geolocation captures the position on the globe, but the design is developed on the map. So there is a need to make a projection, and the CRS defines this projection. Because it's not possible to project a sphere on a plane with no distortion, there is only a local area where distances are kept during projection. And therefore, for every construction project, depending on its location, you will need to set an appropriate CRS to import geolocated data in true length. The CRS to use is usually given by governmental authorities. Otherwise, you can use this website, and for a project in Turkey, for example, use the map to select a location, select projected CRS, and launch the query. You will get the list of CRS usable in this zone. If you don't know which one to take, use the Universal Transverse Mercator based on WGS84. Capture the corresponding EPSG code, ER32635, then go to this resource folder in your CATIA installation. Unzip and relocate the 3DXML file corresponding to the CRS with the same EPSG code. Import it as reference because the CRS is used as a resource and is not to be modified. Then create a site. Enlarge range. Activate geolocation and select the newly imported CRS. Find and enter the coordinates values. Add a terrain part where you will put the 3D terrain definition. You can use this website to get terrain data. Select a zone on the map, download and extract the file that you need. Switch to Terrain application and import the terrain definition file. This button will set the origin of the terrain part from the first point in the terrain file, which is a good practice to avoid geometry being too far from the part's origin. Use this button to color the terrain in elevation. To import an OpenStreetMap, you can create another terrain part and use this button to import the map file that you can generate from OpenStreetMap website like this. And import. As you can see in this example, geolocated data are precisely positioned and they match perfectly. You can turn Z buffer on and off to display or hide wireframe behind the terrain surface. You can check any specific position on Google Maps, for example, like this. You can also verify that measures of topology made from this model, for example here the measure of the distance between two boarding decks on the Bosphorus River, is the same as in real.